नमस्कार, दिस इज दिनेश शर्मा, फिजिक्स की बात में आपका स्वागत। आज की हमारी बात रहेगी एनसीईआरटी क्वेश्चंस एंड चैप्टर इज इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस एंड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड्स। एक बात आप बिल्कुल ध्यान से सोचिएगा कि जब एनसीईआरटी क्वेश्चन आपने कोई भी शुरू करना है तो ऑलवेज ट्राई टू सी कि आपकी कौन सी स्किल उससे आगे निकल कर आएगी। एंड ऑलवेज एनालाइज योर सेल्फ कि जब ये क्वेश्चन करने के पहले और बाद में आपकी स्किल में क्या चेंज आया है। सो वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, दिस इज जस्ट एन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ कूलॉम्स लॉ। टू चार्जेस आर देयर, वन चार्ज इज 2×10⁻⁷ कूलॉम, सेकेंड चार्ज इज गिवन टू बी 3×10⁻⁷ कूलॉम। द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन चार्जेस इज ऑल्सो गिवन टू बी 30 cm। दिस शुड बी चेंज इन टू SI विच कम्स आउट टू बी 0.3 meter। सो question is that how much coulomb's force will be there, how much force will be there and what is nature of that force. ye dono charge ko jab pass rakhenge to ye dono charges kya karenge, they will attract or they will repel. to kyunki charges similar hain to hame yahi se idea hota hai ki these will be repelling each other, lekin kitni force ke sath. so F will be equal to, this is K, I'm writing as you know K is equal to 1/4πε₀, where epsilon naught is called the permittivity of free space because these charges are placed in air. Always see that where the charges are placed. See this question, the charges are placed in air, so we can use this. So this is K for this 1/4πε₀, Q1 Q2 divided by R square, and that comes out to be 9×10⁻⁹ multiplied by Q1 Q2, I'm multiplying from here only, 6×10⁻⁴, just add this, and divided by 0.3 square R square. So 9×54, and that comes up to 6×10⁻³ newton, and this force is definitely repulsive force. Now the second question is also related to Coulomb's law. In the second question we are given that we are having two charges, Q1 is equal to 0.4 microcoulomb and Q2 is equal to -0.8 microcoulomb, right? And the force between these two charges is 0.2 newton. So what is the distance between these two charges, right? So sabse pehle to ye nikal lenge distance kaise niklega. So from Coulomb's law you know F is equal to K, this is Q1 Q2 by R square. So what is R square? R square is K Q1 Q2 by F. You put the values, 9×10⁻⁹, Q1, Q2, just multiply them. So only magnitude, so that becomes 0. I'm multiplying these two, 0.32×10⁻⁶ from here, -6 from here, -12, and divided by force is 0.2 newton. So if I solve them, so this is 16 times, and that comes out to be 144×10⁻⁴. This is R square. So what is R? Take the root. So 12×10⁻². So R is equal to 12 cm. That means if this much force, 0.2 newton force is there, then these two charges, they are having the force. But the question is a bit technical. Question mein ye kaha hai ki this is the force on first due to second. Force on first due to second, right? So what will be the force on second due to first? What do you say? Force on first due to second is given. We have two charges. One charge is here, one charge is here. So this charge is positive, this is negative. So obviously this charge is 0.4 microcoulomb, -0.8 microcoulomb. So these are attracting. So if this charge is being attracted towards that, so this is also being attracted toward this, the same force, because R is same, charges are same. So that means the force will again be same, only the direction will be changing, otherwise everything will remain same. So these are two parts of this question. It's also based on applications of Coulomb's law. Now in the third question, they are talking about one ratio, and this ratio is KE square by GME into MP. This ratio, where this is mass of electron, mass of proton, charge on electron or proton, K and G. G is gravitational constant, and you have to show that this ratio is dimensionless. So it is clear that this part is from gravitational law, this part is from Coulomb's law. So you write that what is this gravitational force, this is G, Yes, M1, M2. First particle is electron, second particle is proton divided by R square. And at the same distance, you're having two charges, the same, because these are charges. So if you apply the Coulomb's formula for the same, so that will be Fe is equal to K, and this is E into E square by R square. If you divide these two, so Fe by Fg comes out to be, yes, this cancels. This is KE square divided by GME into MP. This is the given ratio. And obviously, this ratio is the ratio of these forces. This is electrostatic force. This is gravitational force. So force by force, that should be dimensionless. And next, they are asking that put the values of all these and then find this ratio. That what is the numerical value of this ratio? So you put the values, K is 9 into 10 raised power 9 units. What is, this is Newton meter square per Coulomb square. E is 1.6 into 10 raised power minus 19, you know it well. Charge on an electron, power 2, divided by G. G is 6.67, 10 raised power minus 11. Again, Newton meter square per kilogram square. And this is mass of electron, which is 9.1 in 10 raised power minus 31 kg, and mass of proton, which is 1.67 into 10 raised power minus 27 kg. You put these values and this value will come out to be, they should be in the order of 10 raised power 39, and say it is 2.287. So this is approximately 3 into 10 raised power 39. And the next question in the same, this NCERT part is that what does this ratio signify? What is the significance of this ratio? Now this ratio is telling you that K E square by G M E into M P. That means its value is 3 into 10 raised power 39, right? And we have already proved that this ratio is equal to F E by F G. That means Fe by Fg is equal to 3 into 10 raised power 39. That means electrostatic force is 10 raised power 39 times as compared to gravitational force. So this is the physical significance of this ratio, that Ke square by GMEMP tells you that electrostatic force is much, much more, 10 power 39 times more as compared to gravitational force. So in the first lecture, when we had started in the concept of charges, to wahan par bhi humne is baat pe focus kiya tha. So now is question number 1.4. This question has two parts, and the first question says that what do you mean by the statement that electric charge is quantized? So this is the definition of charge quantization, that when we say that there is a charge on a body, this charge on a body must be the integral multiple of charge on an electron or proton. That is, this is plus minus Ne. That is why we say that charge is quantized. And second part is, now this is the limit to quantization, up to where we can apply this charge quantization. So suppose we are having a very big body, a large scale body, macroscopic body. So on that body, the number of particles will be infinite, right? Many, many particles will be there. Every particle is having charge. That means the distribution of the charges is such that it is continuous. That means it appears that whole of the charge is occupied is by this body. So we don't go in details of this quantization property. So quantization property can be ignored here. So when we deal with the large bodies where the charge distribution seems to be continuous, so here we can ignore the charge quantization because the number of particles is much more. And now in question number 1.5, we are having two body. One body is glass rod, other is silk cloth, and when we rub them, then charges appear on both. Question is, from where these charges are coming? Kya ye charge conservation principle ka violation nahi hai? Aisa question pooch rahe humse. Kya lagta aapko? देखिए रब करने से पहले व्हाट वाज नेट चार्ज ऑन दिस सिस्टम, ये भी न्यूट्रल, ग्लास रॉड न्यूट्रल, सिल्क क्लॉथ भी न्यूट्रल, दोनों पे नेट चार्ज जीरो. एंड व्हेन वी रब्ड, तो जितना नेगेटिव चार्ज सिल्क क्लॉथ पर आया उतना ही पॉजिटिव चार्ज ग्लास रॉड पर आया. मान लीजिए दिस इज प्लस एन ई, तो दैट इज माइनस एन ई.
And if we add them, that again is zero. That means before and after rubbing, the net charge on the system was zero. So this is strictly in accordance with the charge conservation. Yes, charge conservation is followed here. So next question is 1.6. Ye question kya hai ki humne char charges liye hain square ke char corners ke upar. Right? Say this is a square and its ka jo center hai, wahan par ek charge rakha hai. To us pe net force kitna hoga. And beauty of the question is ki yahan par 2 microcoulomb hai. Yahan -5 microcoulomb hai. Ab recall kare, ye question humne already ek video mein kiya tha. Practice formal coulomb's law. Usme ye question properly solve kiya hua hai. Aaj isko hum shortcut mein kar rahe hain. Ab dekhiye, यहां पर पॉजिटिव चार्ज है. दिस साइड ऑफ स्क्वायर इज 10 सेंटीमीटर. सो दिस इफ दिस इज 10, दिस इज 10, सो दिस विल बी 10√2. तो ये होल साइड इज, होल डायगोनल इज 10√2. ये पॉइंट ओ का हाफ हो गया 5√2 ए से लेकर ओ तक. क्योंकि चार्ज यहां है तो हमें सभी की दूरियां यहीं से चाहिए जी, है ना. कैन यू गेट इट? ओके. अभी ये पॉजिटिव पॉजिटिव, ये रिपेल, दिस इज फोर्स ड्यू टू ए. एंड हेयर this is the same value 2 1 2 1. This is positive, positive will repel. So this is force on this due to C. And F, A and F C are equal and opposite. Next, this is minus, this is positive. The charge B is attracting it, F B. And this is minus plus, this is also attracting. This is force due to D. These also are equal and opposite. So these two cancel in pairs and these two cancel in the pair. And net force on this charge is zero. Otherwise, in the previous video, we had calculated it using the Coulomb's formula. So that comes out to be FA was, I think, 3.6 Newton. And due to this, it was coming out to 9 Newton. And ultimately, 3.6 minus 3.6, 9 minus 9, they also cancelled. So net force in this case is 0 if these two are same and these two are same. Any question, link that. These two are same, these two are same, net force should be 0. Right? Seventh question is about electrostatic field lines, which you call electric field line. First question is that electrostatic field line is a continuous curve. This cannot have breaks. कि यहाँ पे रुक गया. ऐसा क्यों नहीं होता है? और हमेशा ऐसा ही क्यों होता है? Can you tell? सोचिए. If there is a positive charge, obviously the field due to this positive charge that varies by E is proportional to 1/r². It varies gradually. Slowly and slowly it will go on decreasing and finally it becomes zero at infinity. And if I draw like this, that means at this point A where no field is there, yahan par hi field zero hogi aur fir se next point pe fir field aayegi. Ab ek aur ye baat sabko clear hogi. That means it decreases gradually and it should become zero at infinity. So it can't have such abrupt breaks ki yahan pe zero ho gaya, nahi to wahan par field zero ho gayi. So there is no logic yahan fir se field kahan se aa gayi. ये ग्रेजुअल डिक्रीज होती है. हमने ऑलरेडी ये ग्राफ किया था कि इस तरह से ये ग्राफ चलता है. तो जब ये जीरो हो गई तो फिर से ऊपर कैसे चढ़ गई है एंड फिर जीरो कैसे होगी, देयर इज नो एक्सप्लेनेशन फॉर दैट. लाइक एंड एक और रीजन भी यहां पर हो सकता है एंड दैट रीजन इज दैट एवरी पॉइंट ऑन दिस कर्व यू टेक सम पॉइंट्स, इट्स टेंजेंट गिव्स द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड राइट ऑन दिस पॉइंट्स एंड द फोर्स इज एक्सपीरियंस्ड एट दिस पॉइंट A also, B also, C also. So if point X is here, force experienced. Here no force experienced. And here also force experienced. So kya charge yahan se jump karke gaya kya? Not possible. Hai na? Force kaise aisa break ko hum just pe nahi kar payenge. That is why we say ki aisa breaks nahi hote. And second part isi question ka hai ki two electric field lines can never intersect. Ye properties of field line mein apne already kiya tha. Because at the point of intersection we'll have two tangent. Two tangent means two direction at the same point, which is never possible. That is why we can say that two field lines will never intersect. Now in the eighth question, recall, शायद पहले आपने कभी किया है किसी एक वीडियो में. This was minus Q and plus Q. This is dipole whose length is 20 centimeter. और question ये है कि इसके center पे कितना electric field होगा. This is -3 microcoulomb. This is +3 microcoulomb. Right? This point is A. This point is B. Say. And this is 20 centimeter. Obviously, half of it is 10 centimeter. So here, what is electric field at this point? This is positive. This unit positive charge is placed here. Positive will repel positive. Field will be in this direction. And here also, this is negative charge. Mind this. field again in the same direction, this field will be at the center, will be double of the field as compared to individual charge. Can you recall? So let us find the field due to B, that is K. K is 9, 10 raised power 9 into source charge, which is 3 microcoulomb, 10 power minus 6, divided by distance square, 0.1 square. So that comes out to be 27. This is 2.7 and 10 raised power 6 Newton per coulomb. And similarly, what is E D2A at the same charge because the value is same? So that also becomes 2.6 10 power 6 Newton per coulomb. And what is the direction of this field? This is along BA. This is also along BA. So what is net field at this point O? E at O will be sum of these two. That will be 5.4 and 10 raised power 6 Newton per coulomb. And next question is, if you place a charge of 1.5 nanocoulomb here, negative charge, just this point, the second question is that now if at this point you place 1.5 nanocoulomb charge here for the same set, then what will be the force on this? So can you find, because now you know the field, so F will be equal to, F is equal to Q times E, right? No need to apply the formula for this Coulomb's law. So Q is 1.5 into 10 raised power minus 9. E, you just found 5.4 into 10 raised power 6. So that becomes 8.1 into 10 raised power is minus 3 Newton. So this is how we can proceed with this question. This question mein center of the dipole ki baat ho rahi thi. Ki center of dipole pe feel kariye ki yahan jo force hota hai, field hota hai, wo individual kisi bhi ke comparison ka double hota hai. Now question number 9 is very interesting. Ninth question mein hume kya diya hai? Charges ka location diya hai in terms of coordinates. Ye kaha gaya hai ki humare paas ek charge hai kisi point A par aur charge ka value hai 2.5 into 10 raised power minus 7 coulomb. And its ka jo location hai, that is 0, 0, and this is minus 15 centimeter. Right? So, dekhenge kaise bana payenge isko? X-axis, this is say y-axis, and this is z-axis, right? X, y, and z-axis. Ab x ka, this is minus x, y ka, this is minus y, and z, this is minus z. Now, when the charge is at 0, 0, minus 15, this is the reason, 0, x is 0, y is 0, and this is at minus 15 centimeter from here. So, this is the position of charge A, which is 2.5 into 10 raised power minus 7 coulomb. And a similar charge, whose value is minus 2.5 into 10 raised power minus 7 coulomb, is located at 0, 0 and plus 15 centimeter. That means, now this charge is somewhere here. This is point B. And its coordinates are 0, 0, 15 centimeter. And this value is minus 2.5 into 10 raised power minus 7 coulomb. I think you can well understand it how these charges have been placed. The question is, first part, what is the net charge on the system? What you say? Net charge. This charge and this charge. Positive, negative. Just add them, that will be zero. Because they have same magnitude. So net charge on the system is zero. The second part is, what is the dipole moment here? So dipole moment P will be equal to either charge into distance. So what is either charge? This is 2.5 into 10 raised power minus 7 and distance. So what is distance? 15 here, 15 here, 30 centimeter. So this is 0.30. And this comes out to be 0.75 into 10 raised power minus 7 coulomb meter. And what is the direction from negative to positive? It should be from P to A. And now in the 10th question, we are given that we are having electric field whose value is given to be 5 into 10 raised power 4 Newton per coulomb, and there is a dipole which is aligned at an angle of 30 degree with it, and its value is 4 into 10 raised power minus 9 coulomb meter. So how much torque is there? Simple. You know torque is equal to P vector cross E vector. You know it well. So what is torque? PE sine of theta. What is P here? 4 into 10 raised power minus 9. What is E? 5 into 10 raised power 4. Sine theta, sine 30 is 1 by 2. So that becomes 2 is cancelled, and that becomes 10 power minus 4 newton meter. So this is the